on, Mike Joy with Darrell Waltrip at Homestead-Miami Speedway. Time to decide the Sprint Cup champion in today's Ford 400.
Mike, this is it. This is what it's all about. You come here, and when this race is over with, you know who the champion's going to be. This is a big weekend for these drivers.
Variable banking, two-groove racetrack, and in 2011, we had a tie here for the championship.
And we may very well have another one, Mike. This is the most exciting race of the year. It's what it all comes down to.
36 races, the longest season in all professional sports. And Darrell, it all comes down to this, the Ford 400.
Getting set to go for 80 laps. Pace car is in. We start 8th, and we are underway. Inside of Truex and Story, and holy shit. Big wreck. And I actually escaped. How about that? Did anyone fly? Oh, someone did.
Is it clear? Hero's now open. Who's on the wall?
Nope, we're gonna stay out. Oh, we got a DNF. I wonder who it is. Anyway, getting set to go again. Pace car is in. And we are back under green.
Okay, let's go get it. One up top.
What the hell? The inside of Bane, sending Keselowski to the wall.
Trying to get to your corner. Watch your outside.
Bush trying to pass me. I don't think so. Inside of Mears.
Car at your door. Up top at your door. Just keep a good pace. You're doing good.
I can see that.
Clear up high.
Going up the track, out of the corner. Alright. And we set a 30.58. As opposed to Biffle's 30.13. Which will most likely go lower as the race goes on. Is he? Oh, yeah, he is. Okay.
We're on the low side. We're on the high side.
Nice try, Jimmie. Way high. And here's one of my championship rivals, Bowyer. going on by Stenhouse. Attempting to anyway. We go up the track, scrape the door. Just a little bit. And now we come up to the back bumper of Newman. We'll go to his outside. Get in, and here comes Ricky Stenhouse. We move down to take evasive action. Getting into Newman a little bit.
Still outside. Go to the low side. One outside. Outside. Hey, come on, buddy. Focus. Let's get that back.
I'm trying my damnedest. Don't you dare. And also, Junior is one of my rivals as well, so. By him.
Three back.
On up the track, out of two, and approaching the top 10. We get by Larson.
Car outside.
Trying to get by Bowyer here.
Car up top.
Larson comes back on the outside. Got a little bit squirrely through one and two there. Now Larson riding my bumper.
Far outside.
Through the corner we go. Once again. Getting into Bowyer slightly.
Go low, go low. Watch your rear. Far
shit.
Outside.
I'm trying, man. It's not working. Bowyer pulls back. Next up is Kenseth. And here is the man who is behind me in points as we went into the race, Jimmie Johnson.
Check your outside.
Kyle Busch backing him up.
Watch your outside. Cover your outside.
Okay, I know the outside. You'll have to remind me.
Car up high.
Trying to go by Jimmie on the inside.
Three wide, two outside. Go down low.
Ugh.
Car at your door.
Scrape this quarter panel.
Car up top, one back.
Going down to the inside of Kyle Busch. And now Matt Kenseth. The top five is just ahead. Being caboosed by Jimmie Johnson. I know caboosed isn't a word. Horny grammar Nazis come at me.
Car up top, just looking. Right side's clear. Car up top, three back. Clear right side.
This guy's up ahead or going a little bit too slow for my liking. So I'm gonna go to the inside of Jimmie. Try not to hit him on the way out of four and we get the move done. Up is either Gordon or Biffle. These two need to settle their score before I get there. Otherwise, I'm gonna do it for them.
We're outside you. At your door up top.
And that's third place. Next up is Truex and. The leader is Tony Stewart.
Three back, coming low. Clear left side.
we're a little bit up ahead yet, so taking it easy right now. So get ahead of steam up high out of two. That'll bring us right up to Truex. Go to his inside.
High side's clear.
Not quite. Not quite. Go to his outside and we scrape the wall.
On the bottom, one back. Inside's clear.
Gordon tried to make a pass at my expense. Failed. Out of four we go. We have Martin Truex Jr.'s draft. Try to get to his inside. Nothing doing there, but here we come out of two with a run. We're to his left rear.
Keep rolling, keep rolling.
Inside, heading through three and four. He gets into us and we manage to make it a second, and the only obstacle between us now is that number 14 of Tony Stewart. A two-time champ, three-time champion, actually. One of very few successful NASCAR drivers to make their way to the sport from open wheel. He got into us, so we pinched him into the wall, and we take the lead. How long can we keep it? That is the question.
Car three back.
You can see him.
Now you're clear.
Now we gotta deal with the lap traffic.
There's your next victim right there.
Where? I'm in the lead. Oh, you mean the lap traffic. Nah, they don't count. He'll pull up in front of Stewart and block his progress. No one's gonna touch me. Have you not seen my car? I got more scrapes and bumps on this than... I'm not gonna make that joke. That's dark. Anyway. Been trying to extend our lead like we did in Phoenix. Doesn't seem to be quite working as well as it was there. Getting a nice run in and through the corners and out.
Whatever you're doing, you just keep doing it.
Taking the high line, see if he can get a run out of two to get by Michael Annette, who apparently has three top tens on the season. I went through the entire points list before the race started, and he has three top tens. Who knew? Possibly all three came at the restrictor plate tracks, but that's beside the point. Got about a second and a quarter on Stewart. Almost getting into the safer barrier and entering three there. And also, I keep seeing debris.
Keep on anybody. Not over yet.
No kidding. I keep seeing debris on the outside in three and four. I don't know if you guys can see it. Let's see. Where is it? There it is right there. And right there.
Clear high.
Probably just marbles, but you know, I don't want to run over it just to be safe. The tires are already junk as it is. Anyway, we got 12 laps till halfway. We have jumped out to a 1.3 second advantage. Am I having fun? I don't know, you tell me. I'm leading a race that I'm not usually good at. And as I say that, I have just lost two and a half tenths on Stort somehow.
You can do this.
50 laps remain in the season.
Caution is out.
And the caution will wave. Let's take a look. Well, that sucked. Oh, let's see. Okay, Mears goes around right into the path of Joey Logano. And all hell broke loose from there. Okay. Not really.
Racetrack's clear. The road's now open. What do you want to do?
Kind of have to pit. Everyone else does apparently as well. Okay. Well, alright, not everyone, but most of them.
Let's switch out the tires, fuel up, and let's add some tape to the grill. You're running pretty cool. We're ready for you, buddy.
Alright, fine. I'll add a piece. Are we good? Yeah, very good. Alright!
Let's hustle here.
Yeah, they even got palm trees in the pit lane. I didn't notice that. Okay, then. Alrighty, let's see where we end up here. Ah, okay, not bad.
Nice job, boys. Great pit stop.
Okay, let's get back in that rhythm. Let's go get these boys.
Alright, so we have come out 11th. Green flag back in the air. Paul Menard is the DNF in this race that I mentioned earlier.
Car up top. Car inside, trying to get to your corner. Three wide, you're in the middle.
Three wide, here comes the dinger down the middle.
Four wide.
I went kind of slow, so I had to move Martin Truex out of the way to avoid him there. Just like Kenseth, and now we're under caution again. Wait, we're not under caution again? What the hell?
Right,
I just
you.
Saw him do a perfect 180.
You.
Oh well.
Whoa,
oh, Bowyer. When will you learn? When will you learn? Out of four, Jimmie Johnson to my inside, and touch me, I will end you.
Low side's clear. No one working the top. You're doing it today.
Doing what? The flip flop? Yeah, you got it.
Car at your door. Up top, at your door. Stay low.
Three wide, two on the outside, and now about to go four wide.
Four wide.
And we slide up the track.
Three
wide, that is Ty Dillon on the inside.
Did he just do that to you?
Yeah, trying my damnedest to not lose any more positions, but I don't know why this happens.
Four wide. One up top. Okay, let's go find your next victim.
There's a bunch of them. Take your pick.
That's it. Come around.
Nope. Not clear.
Keep it steady. High side's clear. Slow side. We're on the inside.
We're finally in the clear. We have lost six positions. Time to get them back.
Oh, you're right.
Not like that, though.
Next time, buddy.
Once again, how is that not a caution?
Car tucked in behind you. Car in line with you. And you're clear.
You know what? I'm not even questioning logic at this game. I mean, they have... Oh, what the hell ever. Anyway, we got some work to do now. Got a lot of it to do, actually. First up, Jimmie McMurray. Don't scrape the wall, you fucker. I'm gonna have calluses on my thumbs by the end of this. In fact, I think I already do have a callus on my left thumb from all the sliding around on the analog stick. Danica Patrick in 16th. In the early stages of this, well, not really early now, but...
Hey, we're halfway there. Keep digging.
16th position at halfway and on the lead lap. That's definitely an improvement. Oh, and of course, her boyfriend is ahead of her. Ricky Stenhouse.
Fight's all clear, bud.
Actually, I shouldn't make that generalization because he's usually not ahead of her. In this, anyway. Up the track he goes. We move both of those guys out of the way.
Nice and easy. Just keep doing what you've been doing.
McMurray pulls back.
On your right side.
And we got another second to go before we reach Tony Stewart. He's up there by himself on the high side. I can keep it out of the wall. Anyway, once again, the nose is the only part of the car that is not damaged. Am I surprised? You bet. How is it not damaged? I do not know, because I hit a bunch of cars with it. Also, I'm not sure if I mentioned this before, but this is the only track on the schedule that's a mile and a half in length that isn't a D-shape. So, let that sink in for a second. Also, this track used to be a rectangle, just like Indy, but it was reprofiled. I don't really remember when it was reprofiled, but a truck series driver died here back when it was still a rectangle, and back in, I believe it was 2007, an IndyCar driver died during practice at this very track. Not really sure if... Yeah, I think the track was, I think the track was given banking back at that point. Yeah, because the track was reprofiled in 2003. Before that, it was flat.
Looking really good right here.
It was as flat as New Hampshire. Anyway, we go by Bain. Next up on the docket is Bowyer. Kurt Busch is the leader after 40, coming around to complete 47 laps. David Reagan having a good run. Getting passed by Bowyer for 11th, or for 10th rather. Now we're battling with him and the lap car, Michael McDowell. Pack is split up in a couple of different sections. Top one being the largest, of course. And then all the lap cars are running by themselves, I think. Three wide up ahead, that is Stewart, Almirola, and Josh Wise.
Car high. Three wide, two outside.
Three wide, two outside. The lap car, Josh Wise, pulls back.
Your door up top.
Trying to get by Bowyer. He gives Stewart a tap. Gets by him. Now we're trying to get by Stewart. Hamlin gets held up by Almirola, so that might be easy picking for us. There. He was inside, we go.
He's coming on the outside. Car outside.
Getting loose through 3 and 4 off of Bowyer.
Inside's clear. 30 to go. 3-0.
30 laps left here at Homestead. Might come down to fuel mileage. I don't know if I did say that. Still trying to get by Bowyer, who I think is the last car I have to worry about. Unless Jimmie Jr. or who else is? Yeah, unless Jimmie or Jr. are in there. Somewhere. Then Bowyer's all I have to worry about at this stage.
Outside.
And I don't have to worry about him now because I just passed him.
Inside
comes Stewart. Goes back in line. Sets up his next move. There's a nice tight pack up here. Going by Almirola for 7th.
Lights all clear, bud. He's coming high. Right side's clear.
Up the track we go out of 4. Keselowski is next. He's beside Michael Annette. He's not anymore because Michael Annette pulled out. A lot of black traffic in this pack up here that we have to negotiate. Dale Jr. has taken the lead.
Clear up top.
And there is Jimmy, so all three of my adversaries are in this pack. They were. Bowyer's back somewhere behind me now.
Stay low. Or outside ya.
Black traffic, move it.
God,
this is as bad as the Cup drivers ruining the Xfinity chase, which they are kind of doing at the moment. Jimmie backing up, slowing down. We get into him, almost spin out through turn three and four there.
No one working the top.
Three wide. Up the track goes Yaley.
Two outside. Clear right side.
To get by him and Elliott. Jimmie Johnson held up by Michael Waltrip.
Keep digging. Got a car behind. Right side's clear.
We're by him, and now all we have to worry about is Dale Jr. And running out of fuel.
Check your outside. Clear on the high side.
Track we go out of four. We might try it on the outside. Can't get there, so we'll transition to the inside instead. Tires are wearing down, and so is my thumb strength. And by the lap car of Avi Labonte.
At your door. They're on the outside.
Dale Jr. is somewhere in that five car pack up ahead of us. Avi Labonte trying to go back by me here, but I'm not allowing it. Here is Junior. Is that him on the inside? Out of four, we'll slide up the track. Like we always do, I don't like saying that. Get a run down the front stretch on Busch. And there is Junior. He has lost the lead to the younger of the Busch brothers, Kyle. Non-chase contender. Up we go.
Stay high.
To the inside of Busch.
Okay, 20 to go.
20 laps left here at Homestead. Battling for the lead and the championship. Dale Jr. to the inside of Kurt Busch. Truex holding me up. Jr. slips back.
Clear right side.
Now Kurt Busch getting by Truex. That's for second. Now battle for the lead. That is between the Busch brothers. The older Busch brother wanting to go to the lead, but the younger holds him off with help from Almendinger.
Car three back. Keep it low. Car outside you. Three wide, you're in the middle.
Oh, yes,
three
I am.
Wide. Two inside. We're on the low
and
side.
Danica Patrick back to 32nd as soon as I mentioned
car
she's
outside.
Doing well.
Door.
To car the inside comes Truex for second. Dinger follows him through. Don't help out the lap cars. What are you thinking?
Just looking.
This isn't
looking
Homestead.
Outside.
Or this isn't Homestead or Daytona, rather.
Go low.
Dale Jr. coming to my outside.
Back.
Throw a block on him.
One outside.
Now he comes to my inside. It's a little bit
ahead.
Loose. Has to slow
wide,
down.
Two inside.
And still the outside. We
just
have the position.
Three wide, too high.
No.
Coming back, coming low.
Shit.
Low side's clear.
Ooh.
Car two back.
It is getting intense here, folks. Sixteen to go. Going for the win and the championship. Kurt Busch to my inside. Get a little bit loose.
Watch your inside. Car inside at your door. On the bottom.
And the caution will wave. That's alright. Thanks, Kurt. Actually saved us.
The safety crews are clear of the track. The road's open.
Oh, you damn right. We need to pit. Ooh. And everyone else will, apparently. Okay. All the lap cars are... Or the lead lap cars are pitting.
Okay, let's gas her up. We need to get those worn tires off. All right, let's do this. In and out.
All right, go for a, you know what, no, I need to fill it up. There's just no way around it. Alright.
Let's go to work, boys. Here we go.
Oh. Hopefully we line up in a decent position when we get out. Let's see. Come on, guys. Let's go. There goes Kyle and Kurt and Junior and Martin. Sixth place? Come on.
Way to go, boys. Nice pit.
Doing great, buddy. That pit stop's gonna make all the difference.
I hope so. 14 laps to go. We're back underway.
Car down low. Got a car low. Hey, come on, buddy. Focus. Let's get that back. Work right there, buddy.
Going up through the middle.
Nice pass.
Now we got Stort's draft.
Keep it right there, buddy. Three wide, you're in the middle.
Going too slow, Stort.
We're up high.
Up to fourth place.
Inside,
three of the four championship contenders are in the picture at this moment. And there goes... Oh, fuck me. Are you serious right now? What happens? Ooh! Oh my god. How many of those are DNFs, I wonder?
I've got a clean-up truck and a vacuum truck out on a racetrack cleaning it up. The road's now open. What do you want to do?
How do I not have damage from that? Well, anyway. Let's see. Ooh, two cars. Are any of them my championship rivals? Let's see. Jimmie? No. Dale? No. Where's Bowyer? Oh, there he is. Fuck. No. All of the championship contenders are around each other. We have 11 to go.
Really good, buddy. Inside.
We're gonna look to pull a similar maneuver that we did at the last restart.
Car closing on the inside. Car at your door. Down low. At your door. Watch your inside. Car underneath. Car inside. Stay up top, you're good right there. Coming on the high side.
Coming on the high side.
Side.
Oh, we got a lap car stopped. I don't know what that was about.
Car outside you. You're good low.
On the low side, to the inside of Biffle.
Got one working the top.
Looking to dispatch Jimmie Johnson.
every position is more points.
Oh, don't you start lagging now.
Watch
don't
your
you dare.
Doing great, man. Outside.
Biffle, back
line
up.
To go. RFI. Closing on the bottom. Three wide.
God damn it, I said back
middle.
Up.
Hold there.
Inside of Bowyer. Jimmie still has the lead.
8 to go.
8 laps to go. That's it, Jimmie. Get back here. No!
Okay, let's get this stuff figured out.
I wonder where Bowyer and Junior are. I know for a fact that we're not going
to
come out
okay,
first.
Okay, we need to be fast here. In and out. Let's go.
Come on. Let's go. Like I said, didn't come out first. When do we ever? Let's see. Oh, fuck me.
Nice pit stop right there, just like we practiced.
Okay, let's get back in that rhythm. Let's go get these boys.
6 laps left.
You just gotta be smooth and calm. 10-4. 3 wide. 3 wide. You're in the middle.
Going to the inside
three
to avoid
outside.
Inevitable pileup that was about to occur. Speaking of a pile-up... Oh, never mind.
Just keep doing what you've been doing. Put it on the left. Looking inside. Okay, let's go get him. Yellow flag, yellow flag.
Oh, yeah, the yellow's out. What a surprise. Okay. What happened here? Alright, so Biffle slowed up. Gets into Logano, and no one flying. Damn.
That truck, are you clear?
The road will be open this time.
Ah, staying out.
Okay, here we go.
4 laps to go.
Car outside, at your door. The leader's a second ahead. Outside.
Damn it, Newman.
High side. Got one work at the bottom. Three wide. Three wide. You're in the middle.
Junior.
Keep a good pace. You're doing great.
Okay, where's Bowyer?
We're on the inside.
There he is. Dickhead.
Top five. Keep working. Stay up.
Bowyer pushing his way to the lead.
Low side's clear.
But that will not fly with me, son.
One up top.
Because we'll go by him and try to go by Kurt.
Clear up top.
And we do it.
One
Here comes Bowyer back to the inside. Two to go. We have a little bit of a buffer now as they fall back for some odd reason. We'll come around through three and four for the final time, or penultimate time, and see the white flag. One lap to go here at Homestead.
Countdown. Here we go. One more time.
Pretty sure this has never happened in the history of NASCAR, a rookie winning the championship. But it is about to happen here as we come out of turn 3 and 4, 10 victories on the season. We win the championship.
Yes, yes, yes! Woo!
Oh.
Way to go, buddy. Great job. Awesome. Awesome, buddy. It's all about right there. We'll see you in victory lane, man.
I don't believe it. But you just won the championship, man. No rookie has ever come close to doing that in the history of this sport. That was incredible.
You're the man.
Like I said, no rookie has won the championship until today.
Woo! Way to go.
Let's burn this fucker down. Now, going for the Polish victory lap. I have literally never won a race at this track in any game that I remember. No grandstands in the back stretch, huh? So we're gonna salute the fans in the infield then we're gonna pull it back up onto the track. Burn it down one last time and pull it into victory lane. Go on board while I do this. Alright, pull it up. How are we? Close enough. Alright, let's do it.
Soak it up, man. Great job today.
Pull it in. And take out the water barrels for good measure. Now, since I forgot to do it last time, let's take a look at the results. 12 laps led on my way to the championship. We win the race, and as I said, followed by Brad Keselowski, Matt Kenseth, Denny Hamlin, Ryan Newman, Eric Almirola, AJ Allmendinger, Kyle Busch, and my closest championship competitor, Clint Bowyer, finished 9th. With Kurt Busch rounding out the top 10. Let's see where Jimmie and Junior finished. Let's see. 17th and 18th. Ooh. Now let's take a look at the DNFs here. What the fuck? I think it was only Menard. Anyway. To the points for the final time this season. I would play We Are the Champions, but I don't want to get copyrighted.
You proved you're the very best on the track. Now, let's take it to the next level and start tearing up those records books.
Two achievements, Fire by Rookie Stripe and Sprint Cup Champion. Final tally. 10 wins, 5 pulls, 15 top 10s. And he won by 8 points. Contract negotiation, you bet on for some familiar. You bet on a new one. So, those of you that have seen this series and are wondering whether or not I'm going to do another one, another season rather, what would you like me to do another season? Let me know in the comments. Until then, thanks for watching the career mode of NASCAR 15. If you enjoyed what you saw or heard, leave a like, and if you want to subscribe, or if you want to see more, subscribe. And until next time. Keep the pedal down, keep on rocking, and go be a champion. Because I did. See you potentially at Daytona.
Lined up in slowly swelling ranks, dealing with cement.